Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom. In today's video, we'll cover how to change the name of your Apple device, whether it's a Mac, an iPhone, an iPad, Apple Watch, even AirPods, and why you might want to. Don't worry about taking notes or anything. You'll find all the steps spelled out on a single page near the end of this video. Let's begin with this iPad. The steps are exactly the same on an iPhone or an iPad, but this is a little easier to see. If we open Settings app, then scroll down and choose General, and then on the General menu, select About. In this top section, you'll see a bunch of different descriptive information for this device, including the model name and number, a serial number, and a descriptive name. Apple assigns this descriptive name automatically when you set up a new device, based on the owner's first name and the device type, like Fred's iPhone. Then each time you get a new device, it might have a new name like Fred's iPhone 2. This is the name that appears when you're trying to connect this device with other devices. For example, when you're trying to share using AirDrop or connect your AirPods to an exercise bike. You can see why using a generic name like AirPods might not be a great idea. To change the name on an iPad or iPhone, just tap here on the name and you'll be ready to type whatever new name you want to give the device. We recommend using something simple and specific like Fred's iPhone 13. If you call it Fred's new iPhone, for example, then what do you call the next one? And the one after that? Keep it short and use upper and lowercase letters and spaces for legibility. And of course, when you're finished, tap Done. If you use AppleID, which we recommend, you can see all the devices connected to your account very easily. Back on the main Settings menu, tap your name at the top and scroll down. Take a look at the list of devices. You may find that there are more devices listed here than you would expect, in some cases, way more than you are currently using, especially if you have family sharing turned on. Over time, as you replace older devices with newer ones, this list gets cluttered up with all the devices you have ever had, because most people don't bother removing the old devices from their AppleID. So the list just gets longer and more confusing. If you rename them, it can be easier to tell which devices on this list are currently in use and which ones can be removed. Changing the name on a Mac computer is just as easy as it was on an iPhone or iPad, but the setting is in a less obvious place. To get started, open System Preferences, either from the Apple menu at the top left of your screen or the dock, whichever is easier for you. Let's zoom in here. Then in the main System Preferences window, open Sharing. And right here at the top of the window is the computer's name, which you can edit directly. There's no Done button. Just close the window when you're finished and the new name will be saved. So we've looked at how to rename computers and phones and tablets, that is, devices that have their own displays where it's easy to edit. For AirPods and the Apple Watch, you can't rename them on the device itself. You have to use an iPhone or iPad that is connected to them. For the Apple Watch, on the iPhone it is paired to, open the Apple Watch app. I usually find it using a quick swipe down in the middle of the screen and then typing the first couple of letters, WA, to search for the app. Once you see it, tap to open it. Now that we're in the Apple Watch app, make sure you're on the My Watch tab. Select General, and then About. This should look familiar. It works the same way as the iPhone and iPad, just not on the watch itself. Tap the first line, which shows the name of the watch, then once again, type the new name and tap Done. And finally, for AirPods, grab an iPhone or iPad that is already paired with the AirPods and put your AirPods in your ears. Now we need to make sure that they're connected. On the iPhone or iPad, open the Settings app as we did before, but this time select Bluetooth. You'll see the list of all the devices you have ever connected to this device, and it should say connected next to your AirPods. Tap on the end of that line about where the little I symbol is, and then tap where it says Name. Type the new name and tap Done. As promised, here's a quick recap of the steps we just went through so you have them all on one page for convenience. To edit the name of your Apple device, if it's an iPhone or iPad, open Settings, tap General, then About, then tap the name. On a Mac, open System Preferences and choose Sharing. On an Apple Watch, on a connected iPhone, open the Watch app, make sure you're on the My Watch tab, then tap General and About. And for AirPods, on a connected iPhone, tap Settings, Bluetooth, tap the device, tap the little I, and then tap Name. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and be sure to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.